The Biden administration, in a public departure from previous immigration policy, has declared that words such as alien and illegal alien are out and non-citizen and integration are in. The administration has asked the heads of Customs and Border Protection, or CBP, and Immigration and Customs Enforcement, or ICE, to update their terminology in response to the vision set by the administration. We enforce our nation's laws while also maintaining the dignity of every individual with whom we interact. The words we use matter and will serve to further confer that dignity to those in custody, says a memo to the agency's leaders dated Monday. The memo described the new words as the preferred terminology and inclusive language. The changes, which are considered guidance, will apply to agency outreach, internal documents and communications with stakeholders, partners and the general public. CBP and ICE leaders are responsible for implementing the vocabulary update. The memo said that the agencies set a tone and example for the country and its world partners and that their communication and conduct must reflect professionalism. Other wording changes ordered include dropping unaccompanied alien children for non-citizen unaccompanied children and assimilation for integration or civic integration. The word alienage would change to non-citizenship, and immigrant assimilation would change to immigrant integration. There are options for undocumented alien and illegal alien, undocumented non-citizen, undocumented individual and migrant. At Citizenship and Immigration Services, the agency that handles naturalizations, green cards, visas and other immigration benefits, acting director Tracy Renault signed a memorandum on February 12 to adopt the administration guidance on the language changes, said spokesman Joe Sowers. Because the word changes don't affect legal language or operational documents, one thing that won't change for any of the agencies is reference to the files on people who enter the immigration system as alien files. Dangerous language that dehumanizes. The changes were hailed by Democrats and advocates who have long slammed the language as offensive. Representative Nanette Berrigan, Democrat California, said the language changes would also help change public perception. These changes are a much-needed shift away from the negative rhetoric weaponized by the previous administration, and a small change that reveals how humanity can be reflected in our immigration policies, said Berrigan, a member of the Homeland Security Committee.